What do you see on your screen?
Sir, it's just like Gandhiji's three monkeys.
Okay, and what do they do?
Sir, एक बुरा नहीं सुनता, एक नहीं देख, बुरा नहीं देखता और एक नहीं बुरा बोलता.
Okay, that's a very cliche. Okay, that's what we have been thinking, and that's what have been taught to us, that we don't hear what is bad, and we don't speak what is bad, and we don't listen what is bad. Is it practically true?
Sir.
Yes, me.
Sir, according to me, in this picture, I think that the communication or the something is going on. The mm-hmm. one man who can't hear that particular conversation, but he can mm-hmm. see and speak what is going on. The okay. woman can't see that conversation, but okay. he can hear. The third okay. man can see it and hear it, but can't okay. speak about that conversation.
Okay, so that's the dynamic communication skills. It may happen that what you are trying to communicate may not be visible to somebody, may not be audible to somebody, and may not be spoken by somebody. So there are things beyond what we see, right? And we have to understand that communication skills is just not what you see. There is an underlying meaning, right? So always remember that once you are in the process of communication, when somebody starts communication, and you are at the receiver's end, you have to find out what exactly does the speaker want to convey, right? It's absolutely true that they represent, these three people represent Gandhi's three monkeys. Yes, somebody raised the hand, but I think it was a mistake. They represent, but there is another meaning attached towards it. Never satisfy yourself with one layer of meaning. I said it before, that there are two ways to read things. One is literal meaning, and the second is figurative meaning. And the third one, which you will understand gradually, is subjective meaning, right? And we need to understand all of them together. One, if you understand literal meaning, try to get the suggestive and the figurative meaning. Then only you will be able to understand what is being shared with you, right? The next question that pops up in my mind relates to this. Does it happen in isolation? Or let's say, does anything happen in isolation? You must आपको पता होना चाहिए कि आइसोलेशन क्या होता है. कुछ ऐसा ही हो जाता है या आइसोलेशन इन द सेंस यू नो द वर्ड आइसोलेशन बिकॉज वी आर इन द पेंडेमिक सो यू हैव टू बी आइसोलेटेड अलोन. कुछ अपने आप में ही होता है या कुछ और भी होता रहता है और एवरीथिंग इज एवरीथिंग कनेक्टेड.
सर लिटरली गांधी जी के ये तीन बंदरों को फॉलो करे तो that's a clear definition of isolation. कुछ देख कुछ बुरा देखो मत, कुछ बुरा सुनो मत और कुछ बुरा बोलो मत, तो वो isolation ही तो हुआ. अगर क्योंकि कोई माल प्रैक्टिस चल रही है तो उसे बिना देखे या बिना सुने या उसके खिलाफ बिना बोले तो आप उस माल प्रैक्टिस के ऑपोज भी कैसे करोगे.
सही है, you nailed it. So nothing happens in isolation. Everything has a relation, everything has a connection. So if I'm giving you the picture, there is a connection between the process of communication and the meanings of communication, and the meaning of what we are seeing, what we are visualizing, what we are hearing, and what we are speaking. There is always a connection. And in terms of communication, when we talk, I know whether you are able to see my full expression, not just facial expression, the entire body language. If you are able to see it, you can relate that the way communication happens, it has the element of verbal, non-verbal, and paraverbal as well. My tone is monotonous, I try to change it. I stress some words. I pause at points. I literally raise my eyebrows at places. So in communication, my dressing style talks a lot. My appearance talks a lot to you. I'm not looking at the camera right in the middle of my laptop. That also communication, that also communicates. So when we communicate, a lot of things happen, and that we have seen in previous sessions. So one has to remember that nothing happens in isolation. Every connection, right? And this is what happens when we start looking at fragments. This is a very simple picture, and we can have this answer, Gandhi's Tribandar, that's it. But remember, in communication, simple things can be very difficult to communicate. Let me give you an example. I don't know about your generation, but in my generation, and maybe in my parents' generation, to say somebody, I love you, and especially to a girl you love or a boy you love, it's almost very difficult. It doesn't come out so easily. Even with your parents, I love you. You can talk to your mother absolutely fine, and she can understand that. But father, a very simple concept. The very simple concept of saying sorry, expressing apology. It's a very simple thing. You know you did a mistake. But instead, we don't communicate that so easily. Communication, I reiterate what I said in previous classes, that communication is very simple. We are making it difficult, and with all the prejudices, baggages, all the egos, I don't know how much ego we carry, and we almost make it difficult to communicate. We try to relate what is irrelevant. We try to make the process so complex that nobody is allowed to enter inside. Ab communication skills bol rahe ho, English language skills nahi bol rahe ho. अगर आपको इंग्लिश लैंग्वेज स्किल्स सीखना है तो हमारा कोर्स कम्युनिकेशन स्किल्स की बजाय स्पोकन इंग्लिश कोर्स होता। हमें कम्युनिकेशन के बारे में सोचना है कि हम अपना जो भी अर्थकथन करते हैं, हम जो भी सोचते हैं, हमारा जो भी फीलिंग्स है, मैं उसे बेहतर तरीके से दोबारा कहने की जरूरत न पड़े ऐसे किस भाषा में उसको मैं कन्वे कर सकता हूं। Language may be different. You can communicate well in English, good, but that doesn't mean that if you are only able to talk in Gujarati and you are not talking in English, your communication skills are poor. No, I don't buy that argument. You can be good at Hindi, and aap jo bhi bata rahe hain na bahut achhi tarah se samajh mein aa rahi hai aisi baat bata rahe hain. ગુજરાતીમાં કહો છો, પણ ગુજરાતી તમે એટલું સરળ કહો છો કે તમારે જે વાત કહેવાની છે મને સમજાઈ જાય છે. યોર કમ્યુનિકેશન સ્કિલ્સ આર બેસ્ટ, યસ, બટ વેન યુ ટ્રાય ટુ કમ્યુનિકેટ ઇન ઇંગ્લિશ યુ હેસિટેટ. ઇટ્સ નોટ ધ પ્રોબ્લેમ ઓફ કમ્યુનિકેશન એન્ડ કોન્ફિડન્સ, ઇટ્સ અ પ્રોબ્લેમ વિથ ધ લેંગ્વેજ દેટ સમબડી ડાઉન ધ લાઈન in the education system or in the society has made a how that English is a difficult language. So our focus for the entire 3 years is not developing English language skills, but communicating right, communicating effectively. Kyunki jab aap job ke liye bahar jaoge, कोई बिजनेस के लिए बाहर जाओगे, कॉलेज से बाहर, आई मीन टू से आप एंटरप्रेन्योर कोई स्टार्टअप शुरू करते हैं, आप सोशल वर्क के लिए जाते हैं, तो आप वहां इंग्लिश नहीं जानते हैं, आपको जो भी आदमी मिलता है आप उसी की भाषा में बोलने का ट्राई करते हैं। सोशल वर्क के बच्चे जब गांव में जाते हैं तो वो उनको इंग्लिश की जरूरत ही नहीं पड़ती है, उनको गुजराती चाहिए, उनको हिंदी चाहिए, लोकल लैंग्वेज चाहिए। जब मैं मार्केट में लोकल रॉ मटेरियल खरीदने जाता हूं तो नोबडी इज कम्युनिकेटिंग इन इंग्लिश एक्सेप्ट आई गो टू द सुपरमार्केट्स। इवन इन सुपरमार्केट्स दे डोंट कम्युनिकेट इन इंग्लिश। द मोमेंट यू स्टार्ट इंग्लिश एंड दे आर नॉट गुड एट इंग्लिश दे विल रिप्लाई यू हिंदी। सो ये सोच के कम्युनिकेशन स्किल्स तो इंग्लिश में ही होनी चाहिए, उसको आप यहां से निकाल दो, ठीक है। इंग्लिश अच्छा हो सकता है, हम करेंगे उसके ऊपर भी पूरा कोशिश करेंगे, लेकिन कम्युनिकेशन स्किल्स एंड इंग्लिश आप ये सोचते हो तो बहुत ही गलत सोचते हो। बहुत सारे मुझे रिस्पॉन्स मिलते हैं, उसमें से ये रिस्पॉन्स मैंने आज इसीलिए पसंद किया, पिछली बार भी मैं यही कह रहा, कम्युनिकेशन स्किल्स इज नॉट इक्वल टू इंग्लिश। ओके, सो आप कोई भी भाषा में बात कर सकते हैं, ऐसा नहीं कि हमें सिर्फ इंग्लिश में ही बात करनी है। इफ यू कैन डू इंग्लिश बेस्ट, इफ यू कांट डू डोंट फील दैट यू आर नॉट गुड एट कम्युनिकेशन स्किल्स, राइट। अगर आपको अटेम्प्ट करना है इंग्लिश में तो आप ये प्लेग्राउंड है आपका, 3 साल तक यहां खेलो, आपका कम्युनिकेशन स्किल्स इंग्लिश में पावरफुल बनाओ, कोई दिक्कत नहीं है। लेकिन जरूरी नहीं है कि आपको फोर्स किया जाए, आपको कोई फोर्स करे कि नहीं आपको तो इंग्लिश ही बोलनी पड़ेगी। वी कैन मैं आपको कभी फोर्स नहीं करूंगा, बिकॉज आई नो कि जब आप फील्ड में जाओगे तो वहां आपको इंग्लिश के अलावा भी कम्युनिकेशन स्किल्स का जरूरत पड़ेगा, एंड दैट इज व्हाट माय फोकस इज। तो बाय नाउ वी नो दैट कम्युनिकेशन इज अ सीरीज ऑफ एक्सपीरियंसेस ऑफ हियरिंग, सीइंग, स्मेल, टेस्ट एंड टच, राइट। एंड अकॉर्डिंग टू कॉलिंस इंग्लिश डिक्शनरी, कम्युनिकेशन एज अ नाउन मींस इट्स एन एक्सचेंज ऑफ इंफॉर्मेशन, आइडियाज और फीलिंग्स, something communicated such as a message, or communication means of traveling or sending a message. It's an art as well as science, and we'll see how it is. This is how it is happening, the process of communication. You speak, somebody listens, and the information is therein. In fact, this is what happens. Can anybody explain what has happened from previous slide to this slide? Take your time.
Sir, in the previous slide, the information was transformed and conveyed properly, but here the boy is trying to hear properly because the information is not properly audible. For example, FM and I are blurred, so it conveys that the information is what we say. The information बराबर नहीं है, उसको समझ में नहीं आ रहा.
सही है. Information या तो समझ में नहीं आ रहा, या तो बीच में जो नॉइज हमने बात किया था, ऑब्स्टिकल्स की जो हमने बात की थी, पूरा मैसेज पहुंचता नहीं है, तो ये होता है। एंड इसमें सेंडर का भी कोई गलती नहीं है और रिसीवर का भी कोई गलती नहीं है इन दिस केस, बिकॉज यू सी द पर्सन इज ट्राइंग टू लिसन, राइट, एंड ही इज नॉट एबल टू गेट द इंफॉर्मेशन बिकॉज ऑफ मेनी फैक्टर्स। Now, we will look at those factors and barriers to communication, but we have to understand that whatever message we try to deliver, there is a chance that the person may not be able to get the message entirely the way you want to communicate, right? So what are those influences? It can be body language, non-verbal communication, language it uses, existing knowledge, assumptions, context, memory, attitude, stress, clarity, culture, listening and writing skills. These are potential barriers to communication, but we will talk about it later when we deal with it. Now, tell me, what are the most common ways we communicate? Read the question carefully.
Verbal and visual.
Okay, one is visual. Okay, so that's one answer. Okay. Okay. Verbal. Yes, verbal, right? Visual and verbal. Communicate through signs. Yes, that's good. That's non-verbal. Through language. Yes, Princy, that's very good. Anything else? What are the most common ways? Through language. Yes. Signs. What else?
Phone.
Yeah. Okay. Now we are talking of instruments. Okay. Look at the answer and you will facial expression. Yes, Ria, that's right. Look at the answer and you will get surprised that these are the most common ways the way we communicate. Okay, wait a minute. Okay. One is spoken word. Second, it's a visual image. Third, body language. And the fourth is written. So in short, okay, I got a response. Codes, yes. Okay. Now, these are the basic ways of communication and basic types of communication skills. When we talk of these common ways, word, visual, non-verbal, and written word. And you can see this four different types of communication skills. We use verbal, that's either maybe written or spoken, and second, non-verbal and listening. So these are four different types of communication skills. Okay, remember this chart, the diagram, this slide, because what you are going to see next would be different one. Now I'm not talking of skills, I'm talking of communication. Now see the difference, see the difference when I'm talking of communication skills, I'm talking of four different skills. Written, that means your language should have that grammar and all that punctuation. Verbal, if you are speaking, your language again needs to be very good. And non-verbal, your non-verbal body language, facial expressions, postures, your appearance, everything counts. And listening, I'm not talking of hearing, I'm saying listening. So these four skills are different than these types of communication. I'm not talking of skills, I'm talking of communication, right? So downward communication, upward communication, lateral or horizontal communication. Can anybody explain me, when you talk to your parents, which type of communication does it happen?
Verbal and non-verbal.
Oh my gosh. I'm not talking of skills, my dear. I'm talking of types of communication. That's what I explained.
Downward communication?
Downwards. Okay. Seriously? Okay. Somebody responds on chat. Okay. There are two responses.
Up.
Emotional.
Upward.
Okay. Upwards. Okay. Okay. Very interesting.
Upwards, sir.
Seriously, I am surprised that you talk to your parents in upward communication. Wow.
No, sir. It's lateral or horizontal because peers at the same level for information.
Yes. That's what peers. I need you to understand. That when we say downwards, your parents are talking to you, and when you say upwards, your children are talking to parents. That's not the case. You see the difference, what it suggests here. See, the definition is given, highly directive, from senior subordinate. You assign duty, you give instructions to inform, to offer feedback, approve, to highlight problems, and etc. etc. So that's downward communication. So there is a chance that you may receive instructions, directives from parents. That's absolutely fine. But it's not downward communication as such when we think in terms of types of communication. And when you talk to your parents, it's not upward communication. You may be talking about problems, you may talk progress, you may seek approval, but they are not, if your family is based on hierarchy, then you may be right. If your family considers everybody equal, then horizontal. And that should be the case. When equal status from the same kind of understanding, same cultural background, same family values, I think that can be called peers, near and dear ones with which you identify yourself. So when we say downward communication, we don't say in the concept of parents or family. Even upward and downward, they don't fall into that category. You may disagree with me, that's not an issue, but then I don't see upward and downward happening at family level. It happens at horizontal level. Now let's understand this with a chart like this. The hierarchy where the top executive, the director, communicates to the foreman or a laborer. He may not be talking to laborer as such. He may be directing somebody to talk. So you can see that direction. The director will never talk to a laborer or a foreman in an industry or in a company. He will give it to vice president. Vice president will give to the general manager. General manager will talk to manager, and manager will talk to supervisor. And then supervisor will communicate what message has been delivered by the director to the foreman. You see what I'm trying to tell you, that there are places where the message is going to change from director to foreman. But if it follows from top, it is downward, and if a foreman is talking to director, it is upward, right? So I think that will help you to understand this figure, this chart will help you to understand the downward communication is from top to bottom, and upward communication is from bottom to top, right? There are different channels. We will look at those channels when we say forms of communication, that what are the forms in which downward communication can happen or upward communication can happen. Look at this. It's a horizontal communication. Now, in the first figure that we have seen, manager, and then manager talks to supervisor, and then foreman. Here, manager manages three supervisors. So he will be talking to supervisor 1, 2, and 3. But then